Mum had prepared the children food and sat down with them, and out of the blue, Caden just threw food.
It's on your eyebrow.
Is it?
Mum was laughing at his behaviour. Really? I decided to go and talk to Caden to see if he's even aware of his behaviour and how that affects his mother.
You know, earlier on when you was eating at the table,
yeah,
and you got your sandwich and you threw it at Mummy. Do you think Mummy was happy or sad about that?
Mad.
You think she was mad? Right. Is that naughty behaviour or not naughty behaviour to throw your sandwich?
Naughty behaviour.
How do you know it's naughty?
I know it's naughty because my mum was mad at me. So that's why.
Was you happy when you threw the sandwich, or was you sad, or was you mad? Like, what was
sad?
You were sad when you threw the sandwich. What was you sad about?
I was sad about because my mom was being mean to me.
Oh.
This boy's behaviour is impulsive, and he becomes very angry. But he does know the difference between right and wrong. I can't help but feel sorry for him. You know, who's helping this little boy so that he can learn to behave differently?
Put these shoes on so we can go to the gym.
No!
In the evening, Mum told me that she was picking up her friend to go into the gym where they were going to have a workout. This is something that Mum does most nights of the week.
We usually go from 6 to 8. Yeah. Kids club closes at 8.
And I think I just stared at her face like, are you sure? But off they went.
It's nice to be able to go to the gym. The kids can play and I just need some time for myself.
So how long will they be in here now?
Usually about an hour. Yeah. We work out.
This is bath time now. This is the bedtime routine. And now you're going off down to the gym. And the kids are going to now be stirred up and riled up. I know that Mum gets really stressed out being a single parent. And so going to the gym helps her to release that and keep her fit. But at that time of the night, with your kids, keeping them up all hours. The fact is, Mum could get a DVD, get some weights to use in the house once these kids were in bed.
Caden, Kayla!
By the time Mum finished working out in the gym, Caden was totally riled up. And poor old Kayla, I mean, she was just bored stiff. I mean, let's face it, Kayla hasn't had any attention all day.
Does Mummy spend a lot of time having to chase Caden and be with Caden all the time? Do you get much time with Mummy? No?
Poop! I'm pooping your face right now.
Okay, come on.
We leave the gym and he's kicking off.
Running at you.
Stop it right now, that's not funny.
Stop.
And no doubt, he's kicking off. He's hungry, he's tired, yet he's got second wind.
I think we've got trouble brewing when I get back home.
Kayla, do you want these ones? Caden, look, don't hit your sister.
Back at home, Mum had to get two cranky kids ready for dinner and then bath time.
Caden, stop it right now.
You're spraying too much.
Stop right
now. You're spraying too much.
It must have been around 9 o'clock before Mum even got the kids into their bedrooms. It's just too late.
It's mine.
And then Kayla decided that she would get some of her mum's attention today by kicking off.
Kayla, get in your bed.
No.
Yeah.
No.
Caden was acting out and she fed into it and then they both ganged up on me.
Stop.
No. Leave me alone.
Mum hadn't put anything in place to wind these kids down. No stories, no cuddles. I think she'd just run out of steam and she was like, just get to bed. Like, I'm over this, I'm done with this.
Mom,
it's 9:30, this is the last time.
Turn the TV on.
I'm gonna turn it on and I'm going to shut the door.
So basically the TV's on and hopefully they fall asleep. That's your hope, right?
Yeah. Good thing I didn't stay long at the gym.
And Mum's laughing. Not funny.
You came from the gym tonight.
Right.
Had you have done your usual, your kids wouldn't have been in bed till like 20 to 11.
Right.
At the earliest.
Yeah.
Mum wasn't understanding the whole picture.
I mean, this woman needs a routine. You just can't pick your kids up and run them around everywhere that's convenient for yourself and not have any consistent meal times or bedtimes.
So now you're going to do your studies for your degree?
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
No. Kaden. No. No. Do not throw it. Do not hit me.
There's been so much aggression, so much. And if Mum doesn't get on board to change these circumstances for her children, then there's not going to be much hope for them.
Well, it is late, and tomorrow morning we are going to need to sit down and have a family meeting because there's much to be discussed.
I've seen so much today. It's very clear for me what needs to be done in this house.
Hello.
Hi.
Let's talk about behaviour. It's appalling. When I walk into a house and I see children exhibit the kind of behaviour that I see Caden show, with his punching and biting and spitting, I know I'm looking at a child who's broke, who's screaming out for help, but you laugh. You laugh at that behaviour. It's not funny.
And I guess if I'm laughing, I'm laughing at myself, like, in disbelief, like, oh my God, did this really just happen? Are you kidding me right now?
Are you gonna be the family that I switch on the television and see that another young boy is now stealing out of shops, is now battering his wife, is now inside and doing time? When are you going to stop laughing so that you can change?
I realize that that's where I'm like, I've got to change it.
Let's talk about bedtime. Bedtime was a joke. The kids run hoops around you.
I guess I just accepted it. Eventually they'll go to sleep.
Your kids weren't listening to you. You put the telly on. It's lazy. What about you sitting down with your kids and reading them a bedtime story? What time do they get from you?
I don't know.
Nothing. You're there, but you're not giving them anything. I mean, what are you thinking?
I don't know.
Well, you're gonna have to start thinking. The next thing I want to talk to you about is the safety in the home. We're seeing Caden running out of the house, and yet you don't have a lock that's secure.
Yeah, he broke it.
There's got to be some measure of safety where you start to realize, I need to make sure that I've got locks, I've got to make sure that the house is secure over nighttime. Don't you think it's a bit lazy that you haven't just put a lock on that door? I mean, it's your responsibility to look after your two children. Routine is major in your house because you don't have a game plan.
I've tried to set up routine. It just...
I'm not buying the word try. And I really cannot let you off the hook because you're a single parent raising two kids. You obviously think it's okay to be down the gym at 8 o'clock when really your kids should be in bed. What part of that's okay? I mean, how did you justify that to yourself? I'm curious.
You know, working all day long, if I don't go to the gym, I don't have the energy to keep up with them.
I understand that keeping healthy is an important part of you being able to give back. I understand that. But you have two children who need to have established sleep patterns.
Right.
I expect 100% of your focus, of your attention and your intent to make change. So are you still on board?
Of course.
Okay, thank you.
Coming up on Super Nanny.
Give me the stick and go to your room.
Caden puts up a fight.
Caden.
Ashley.
And Mom lashes out at Joe.
I don't get help from anybody. Anything I need or I want, I get myself.
When Super Nanny returns.